What is going on, guys? It is the Red Sky here with another LEGO review. Today we are doing 2013. Z-95 Headhunter. This is at 75004. It's 373 pieces. It comes with 3 figures. 501st Legion Chrome Trooper, 501st Pilot, and Pong Crow. Now, I bought this set used off of a website, so it's in a bag, but here is the instruction manual and a bag of pieces and stickers. So let's get to building. Hello guys, I just finished the Z-95 Headhunter. It took me about 30 minutes to build, but I started late at night, so I had to stop because I messed up on the engine. I had to stop with the same engine. I just finished building it this morning. So the set is all complete, except for one thing. I had to go and find one piece. But other than that, the guy who had it kept it pretty good. He just bought it, looked at all the pieces, put it back in the package, and sold it. But, alright. It does, the 3 minifigures are actually really easy, and let's go ahead and show you them. Alright guys, here is the 501st clone pilot. This is like all the 2013, the one before it sets with the clone trooper. They have that special face. Not like nowadays where it's an actual angry face on all of them. He does not have 2 faces. He is a unique, exclusive to the set for now. I really like his helmet. His helmet has some pretty nice detailings on it around the side up here. The guns come in the ship, so I'll show you those when I get to the ship. And he has a little oxygen breather right here. And he has the standard clone stormtrooper detailing on the back. So let's move on to the next minifigure. Alright guys, here's the 501st Legion Clone Trooper. Like I said, face is the same. His helmet's pretty cool. It's starting to become the Phase 3 armor type of armor. It's got the blue streak down the front, and that's pretty much it. His gun also does come with the actual ship itself. He's got some blue arms and a blue line down his chest piece. And there's some little blue linings on his leg. On his back, it's basically the same as a stormtrooper armor. Alright, let's move on to the final minifigure. Alright, so this character I actually think is a pretty cool character, and it's one of the main reasons why I bought it. This is Pong Krell. He is exclusive to this set. You can only find him here. He's got a double-bladed green lightsaber and a double-bladed blue lightsaber. And this is actually 2 pieces. Here is his head piece, and then here's his torso piece. I'm gonna look at this real quick. This move lightsabers. There's not really a lot of details on the front, but his face is pretty cool. And here's some arms sticking out where you grab lightsabers, and no printing details on the back. And on the chest piece, he's got Jedi robes. Even though he does turn to the dark side in the Clone Wars, because this set is based off the Clone Wars. There's nothing really much you can say besides he's got that normal Jedi robes with some white arms, some black gloves. And it's hard to put it back together. Alright guys, that was Palm Crow, and now let's actually move on to the set. Alright guys, here's the actual Headhunter itself. I'm going to give you a quick 360 turn, then we'll look at the detailings. Alright, let's move on. Alright, so here is basically what you get with the set. The wings are really nicely detailed. These engines are a separate build itself. It's got a sticker here where the exhaust is and the engines on the back. And Scott's, I'm pretty sure these are guns on the side of the wings here. Same on both sides. And then you can open this up to reveal the pilot. The clone pilot, you can sit down and control the ship. You gotta lay him down here, and there's a sticker here with the controls. I really like this back part here. It's incredibly detailed and looks exactly like it does in the show. And then you can open this hatch up, which reveals this little thing, which comes with one gun. Unfortunately, it's only one gun. So the sets plus some lenses, and then there's a little gun here. Pick it up. You can put my hand on it first. Let me flip it over. Actually, on the bottom here, there's a little shooter. Let me just take that out real quick. It can come down, and then you just keep pushing it and fire it. I'm not going to fire it because it's aiming right at me. And the landing gear are retractable. You can move them up any way you want them to. Right, that's pretty much it for the look at this Headhunter. Alright guys, that was the 2013 Z-95 Headhunter. This set is actually one of my favorites, and even though it doesn't have a lot of pieces, I love the exclusive figures. They all were brand new to this set. Oh no, and only one of them went on to its own separate set, which was the Clone Trooper. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. Remember to go down to like and subscribe, and always remember to stay you. This is the Red Sky signing out.